Consent thou not. In fact, bro, James 5 verse 7. James 5 verse 7. Look at what James said. James 5 verse 7. Nobody.
Be patient, therefore, brethren, unto the coming of the Lord. Behold, the husbandman waited for the precious fruit of the earth, and hath long patience for it, until he received the.
Sorry, but verse chapter 4, verse 6, then 7.
But he gave it more grace.
Give it more grace.
Wherefore, he says, God resisted the proud.
God resists the proud.
But giveth grace unto the humble.
Giveth grace unto the humble.
Submit yourself therefore to God. Resist the devil.
Resist the devil.
And he will flee from you. Draw nigh to God. And he will draw nigh to you.
Thank you. But how can we talk to God and God respond, confirming what we have heard from a woman? If not that we are consistent in the things that it was. You have been taught about worship. You have been taught many things about God, the celestial church of Christ. But you choose to be defiant. You choose to be disobedient, following your own mind. I cannot come and kill myself. You have forgotten that the time of problem is coming, that you need God ever than before. Have you noticed at this juncture in the world, we don't know who we should believe anymore? Even your prophet, you are doubting him. Even your shepherd, you are doubting him. Even your pastor, you are doubting him. Everybody now is now filled with lies. Everybody wants to drive the test car. And as a result of that, everybody is putting lies to his daily bread. He has been given 100% gift. Out of 100, 90 of it is lie. Nobody wants to wait for God's time anymore. Be very careful that we will not die like small prophet in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be careful of deceit. Be careful of the one speaking when God has not spoken. Look at second lesson. I know Apostle Paul, verse 9. Second lesson, Acts 30, verse 9. Apostle Paul, he descended and realized this sorcerer, Elymas, is a wicked man. He's not speaking from God. Then he cast him. Verse 9.
Then Saul. Who also is called Paul.
Also called Paul.
Filled with the Holy Ghost.
He was filled with the Holy Ghost.
Set his eyes on him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You are not responding. Hallelujah.
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 The difference between you having Holy Spirit and being filled with the Holy Spirit. But if after having the Holy Spirit, now look at today's worship now. God has given us our prayers and give to every one of us his Holy Spirit. That was the way you get home tonight for sleeping. That you should not ask God's Holy Spirit. If you fail to ask, and you rely on the little quality he has given to you today, that is the rage you will be operating. And hence, when greater tribulation arises against you, such a man will fall. Because you are not filled, you only have. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Even in the world, there's a difference between you having money and filled with money. Yes or no?
Yes.
A empty rich man and a wealthy man. Rich man will be very careful with spending money. But wealthy man will spend, you beg him to stop. So having Holy Spirit does not mean you are filled with the Holy Spirit. Take a lesson from Apostle Paul. The Bible said he's filled, which means according to that English. We all went to school. would say his bucket is filled already, you need no more Holy Spirit, isn't it?
Yes.
But no, Apostle Paul always asks Holy Spirit. Fill with the Holy Spirit, because he understands his calling as an apostle. Because everywhere he goes about to preach, he's very sure that there will always be a spirit or a man or a group of persons to go against the true word of God. Can we swag?
And said,
O full of all subtlety
and all mischief.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And subtlety has already been in existence from Genesis chapter 3, verse 1. The Bible said, in Yoruba, only a jokufu and reke reke, filled with subtlety. That is one of the weapons of the enemy. Enticement, also known as subtlety. Who is there? English 3:1.
Now, the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Of every animal on earth, the snake is the most cunning. I don't know how to put it. We all know that there are some kind of species of snakes that if they come into this church right now, we change his color to this color of this brick. Whereby you will know what you are seeing is snake. But you go nearby and just sting you. That is who humans are. That is who those that will take you out of your way will always be. They will come before you as friends, as helpers, but be very sure they are there to take you out untimely. Always learn to discern. I pray that the spirit of discernment to know evil from good and good from evil this day, the Lord shall be upon us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I will see what.
That child of the devil.
That child of. Look at Paul. And even it's me and you, you start asking, she wants him to tell you, you know her before. But because you know this, you understand this thing this man is saying is evil, then I need to deal with him.
Thou enemy of all righteousness.
Enemy of all righteousness.
With thou not case to prevent the right way of the Lord.
It's okay. I'm very sure you've learned to spend this test this morning. Be very careful. Always learn to confirm every word from God, every prophecy from God, every dream from God, every prophet, for always confirm. Because we have got to report by everyone needs to have his or her own God. You remember, it has a permission. Truly, we have only one God. But in that one God, everyone we have his or her own portion. So that whenever you come across problem, you'll be so sure of yourself that I will call on my God and my God will answer me. Micah 4 verse 5. Let's end it here. So if every one of us starts going home thinking I don't need God, you always need God, because we are getting to the point whereby everyone has become liar. Only you are the true person living on earth. Who is there? Make up his father.
For all people will
want
everyone in the name of his
God.
All people
will walk everyone
in the name of his God.
Can you hear that? Not the name of the God of Israel, in the name of his God. So if your God is Shango, walk in it. If my God is the God that made the heavens and earth, and walk in it. But what will show the supreme God above every God is the result of that God. If you have God and you're not using your God, you are doing yourself more harm than good. Start using your God. Prophets will come and they will talk their own. Pastors will come and they will talk their own. Dreamers will come and they will talk their own. Fathers and mothers will come, they will talk their own. It is left to you to confirm their word from your God. Because liars are everywhere. Deceitful people are everywhere. They are surrounding you. More generally, you the Christians, a surround is taken out. It is left for you to call on your God, and God show you the way. For example, look at business traders, business owners. Different kind of business is popping up almost every day. Pay 10,000, collect 20,000 under 1 hour. And all that. If you are not careful to ask from God, God, which one should I do? You don't go and bring all your money and such person end in the emptiness. I pray. May we not end in emptiness in this month in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Stand up on your feet.